Gigi Hadid has hit back at people commenting on her weight with the real reason her body shape has changed. With New York Fashion Week in full swing, Twitter trolls have been the first to criticize Gigi about her appearance on the catwalk. The supermodel hit back by educating her followers that this is due to being diagnosed with Hashimoto's disease, which, among other things, changes the way her body digests food. She tweeted, "Although stress and excessive travel can also affect the body, I have always eaten the same. My body just handles it differently now that my health is better. I may be too skinny for you. Honestly, this skinny isn't what I want to be, but I feel healthier internally."
Real life princess Blake Lively just shared a post-baby weight loss snap, and her body is banging. Blake dropped 27 kilograms after giving birth to her second daughter, Ines, and thanked her trainer, Don, for kicking my ASS into shape. 10 months to gain, 14 months to lose. Thanks, Blake, for being so real. And she's not the only one on Instagram. Kylie Jenner's back. The baby mama hit the gram whilst out for a drive in a hot red tracksuit, and all the comments are like, "She's back!" Heart eye fire, purple heart emojis, and thousands of LB like backs. I think she's busy. Speaking of Kardashians, Kim's waist is the smallest it's ever been. The reality star just shared a video from last year's book club meeting, but before her gal pals like read books and stuff, Courtney was all up in Kim, like, "I can't take your hips seriously right now. Your waist is so small and your hips are so big." To which Kim revealed that her waist is now just 24 inches. How does she find jeans that fit? Is she wearing North's clothes? YouTube finally has consequences for posting harmful content. And whilst they're not blaming Logan Paul directly, they're basically saying it's all his fault. The bad actions of a few creators can affect the entire community. Today we're announcing new steps we're taking to address channels that upload harmful content. So here's the info, guys. The new rules apply in the rare event when one creator's actions harm the entire community. And here they are. 1, YouTube may remove a channel from Google Preferred and also suspend, cancel, or remove a creator as YouTube original. 2, YouTube may suspend a channel's ability to serve ads and earn revenue. 3, YouTube may remove a channel's eligibility to be recommended on YouTube. I prefer Dua Lipa's version, to be honest.
At least 17 people have died after 19-year-old Nicholas Cruz allegedly opened fire in a school in Florida. In the hours after the shooting, numerous people and celebrities, including Kim Kardashian, Ellen DeGeneres, Chelsea Handler, Reese Witherspoon, and many more, have been calling for stricter gun control laws to help prevent such horrific attacks. Kim Kardashian tweeted, "Prayers won't do this, action will. Congress, please do your job and protect Americans from senseless gun violence." Chelsea Handler tweeted, "We have to elect candidates that are not funded by the NRA in November. We have an opportunity to elect candidates who won't allow kids to go to school and get shot. It is disgusting how many times this has happened, and Republicans do nothing. You all have blood on your hands." They're right. What's needed are stricter gun control laws that stop basically anyone who's over 18 picking up an assault rifle from pretty much anywhere. You can literally buy guns at Walmart. And while prayers and platitudes clearly aren't working to stem gun violence, some members of the Republican Party were quick to tweet their support and condolences to victims of the attack. Which is nice, but somewhat hypocritical given the significant funding they've received from the National Rifle Association and various other gun support groups. Good thing we've got the New York Daily News, who've been retweeting support messages of senators with details of the support they've received from the NRA. They pointed out that Marco Rubio, US Senator for Florida, received $90,205 in campaign donations from gun rights groups during the 2015 to 2016 campaign cycle and received an A+ grade from the NRA. Rubio has received $3,303,355 over the course of his career as an elected official. After Trump tweeted his prayers and condolences to victims' families, the Daily News reminded us he was the first sitting president to address the NRA's annual convention in more than 3 decades. And in Trump's speech to over 10,000 NRA members just last year, he said to them, "You have a true friend and champion in the White House." Meanwhile, he's currently tweeting that no child, teacher, or anyone else should ever feel unsafe in an American school. Well, if the president of the United States wants to get a head start on that, maybe he should stop championing guns and befriending their support groups.